Turner with us here courtside after your team got a 75-57 win here in this exhibition game tonight. Russ, a final tune-up for your club to get things going on Tuesday, but what did you take away from what you saw from your team tonight?
Well, we got through it, is the way I said in the locker room. I don't think we were as aggressive and competitive as I would expect us to be, but that's why you play an exhibition game with a real crowd. I don't think it's easy to come in here, especially given what we've gone through here in the Bren. We've been out of the Bren for a little while. I don't think it was easy for us to come in and compete at a high level. And we did not do that as well as I expect us to do. But we played 16 guys. Now, that's also not easy to do. That's not what it's going to be like on every night. We remain a work in progress, but we are a group that can be effective. Tonight, we didn't take very good care of the ball. We got frustrated that some shots from deep didn't go in. And I think some of that is what sometimes can happen on the first night in front of a crowd. Hopefully this will help us on Tuesday. We're going to have to play a lot better against the schedule that we've got coming up. If we expect to be successful, we're going to play a lot better than we did tonight.
It's hard to take too much out of a game like this. That being said, you can tell there's some guys that clearly improved. I thought Hayden Welling had some moments tonight, Langston Redfield. And then you bring in a young guy like Darren Saron, who looked like he had some pretty nice moments as well. What were your takeaways from guys stepping into new roles tonight and trying to elevate from where they were a year ago?
Well, I agree with all the three that you mentioned. I thought Hayden, with his energy and physicality, was effective. A couple of big offensive rebound baskets, which I know he can give us. Langston, it's great to have him out there. I trust him as a competitor. In my mind, he's a proven player, even though he sat out last year. We know he can do some good things. I thought Darren had a good second half. I thought he looked really shaky in the first half. He had some shaky plays in the second half, too. But it's not easy to play in your first game on a college campus. We know his talent is there. I'd like to see him more aggressive in his mentality maybe than he was tonight, both on offense and defense. I thought the offensive style they played, we were emphasizing being aggressive on the ball and discipline, and I thought we needed to be aggressive. And I expected us to have more fouls than we had. We were almost too cautious about playing the ball with our length, and we're going to have some good film to learn on from that. Their 5-man shot 15 threes. We knew that's what they were going to do. We never adjusted, to a different style of defense because I wanted to keep some things from being on video for the early part of the season. I was surprised that our big guys weren't able to be more dominant with their size. That's a credit to UC, a credit to Cal State San Marcos. And maybe something that's going to be good for our big guys. We got to get a little bit better.
Well, I want to talk about San Marcos just for a moment because, again, we all know Nick Booker and the relationship there. They have a lot of Division I players that are playing in a program like that. As far as an exhibition goes, I think they have a chance to be a pretty good Division II team. Is that something when you're scheduling an exhibition game to maybe have an opportunity? Okay, these guys are going to give us a little bit of a test to get set for the season.
I wanted to play the game for Book. He's my guy. He worked here. It's a big opportunity for their program to play against us and a little bit of a payday. That's the reason we took the game. The style that they are playing is a lot like UC San Diego, and it's a difficult style to play against in some ways for us. It demands that our big guys assert themselves more than we asserted ourselves tonight. I thought Devin did that. Devin looked like an assertive UC Irvine type big guy. I thought Hayden did a little bit of that. I didn't think Bent was able to do enough of that, or Dean was able to do enough of that. I know those guys will learn from that experience tonight. I know that they're going to be ready on Tuesday because we've seen enough from them. And it's never about one position. We didn't shoot the ball well, so they were able to pack the paint against us. They were aggressive around our catches in the post. I didn't think we took good care of the ball. And I didn't think we had enough of a rebound impact in this game, given the size advantages that we had. It felt a little bit to me like they outplayed us, that they played a little harder than we did, that they won some loose balls that they wanted worse than we did. And that might be the best thing for us to have over these next 4 days of practice before we play on Tuesday.
a lot of work, big game coming up Tuesday to get the season started. We'll have it for you, and looking forward to that coming up Tuesday night at San Jose State. Russ Turner, thanks.
All right, thanks, Trent.
All right, that's Russ Turner, the head coach of the Gators. We got Devin Tillis with us tonight. Dev, a rebound shy of a double-double. I was kind of waiting for that that 10th rebound to come in.
They took me out, man.
But a pretty good showing from your team tonight. Mm-hmm. Russ Turner was talking about you kind of playing the style and the with the effort that he expects from your bigs tonight. How important was it, did you feel like, for you as a veteran guy to help set the tone a little bit for all the big guys?
Man, you know, it's very important. You know, coming from, like, years past, you know, we had Colin Welp and all those guys that would set the tone for me. So, like, coming in this year, I knew I got to be one of those guys to set the tone for the young guys and, like, show them how we do things around here. And that's what I came out and did from the jump.
I know that getting ready for a team like San Marcos is very different when you guys go and take on a Mountain West opponent coming up in San Jose State on Tuesday. But here in an exhibition, what are some of the things that you felt like your team was able to get out of this performance tonight?
You know, we're going to have a lot of good tape to watch tomorrow. But I think the biggest thing was, like, creating energy. Like, that's what we need to do. When we have energy, we're good. We run the floor, we rebound, we play big. Like, we're really good. That's the biggest thing. We can't deviate from what coach is, you know, telling us to do, you know, move the ball, stuff like that. But like I said, the biggest thing is just creating energy for our guys.
Excited for Tuesday?
Yes, sir. Big time.
It's going to be a fun one. Devin Tillis, thank you so much, man. We'll see you. I think we're going to see you plenty in these postgame interviews. All right? Looking forward to it.
Yeah,
all right?
Looking forward to it, too.
He's Devin Tillis, our player of the game tonight. And that's going to just about do it for us here on the Anteater Basketball Radio Network. As we say, good.